This is the second part of lesson 11.3. So we just have one more proof left in this lesson. And so if we look at the picture, kind of take a look at what it shows. We've got some things marked. Now, since this is called angle 2 right here, I could call it angle 2 instead of saying angle DCA. And that makes it easier. So if it's labeled like that, you can just say angle 1 and angle 2. I've got some givens right here, so let's look at the givens. It says that AB is congruent to CD, and that's already marked. Angle 1 is congruent to angle 2, that's already marked. So I've got my givens already marked. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to prove that two pieces are congruent. I'm trying to show that this piece is congruent to this piece. And so think of how we've done that in other problems. If this triangle was congruent to this triangle, and I turned the one around so that things would match up, these two sides would be the same. So my first goal, my intermediate goal, is to first prove that those two triangles are congruent. Then I could use CPCTC. So that's what we're going for here. So first of all, it gives us the opportunity to list our givens. And so our givens, I'm just going to state these two things right here. So I'm going to say AB is congruent to CD, and angle 1 is congruent to angle 2. So those are my givens. Now, number 3, it's got a line over the top, and it says congruent. It says reflexive property, so it looks like segments. So look at your picture. What segments would be congruent because of the reflexive property? Think about what that means. It means something's congruent to itself. So looking at the picture, it's going to be AC is congruent to AC. So that one. Then number 4, it says triangle blank is congruent to triangle blank. So look, do I have enough? Look at this triangle. I've got a side, an angle, and a side compared to a side, an angle, and a side. And so I can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle. Now be careful. So I started out with angle A and B and to C. So I'm going to have to go from C to D to A. You've got to make sure you go in the right order so that everything matches up. Otherwise, what we do next won't work. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do now, since the triangles are congruent to each other, I'm wondering, so like AD, look at what, keep our eye on the ball. AD is congruent to CB. It's all matching up. So I can say that AD is congruent to CB because of why? I've used the congruent triangles test. So now that I've done that, I can say. So just in summary, using CPCTC, the number one thing to remember is you only use it after a congruent test has been used. So if you haven't used side, angle, side, or side, 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 or angle, side, angle, if you haven't used one of those tests, you cannot use CPCTC. If you haven't already made a statement that this triangle is congruent to this triangle, you cannot use CPCTC. And that's the number one thing that people do wrong. They do CPCTC in place of a congruence test, or they do it way ahead of when they should do it. That's not what you use to say that two things are congruent until after you've said that two triangles are congruent. So just make sure that you're careful about using that.